So, Ohm's law, I taught you in class 10. Yes, remember? There's a law which is conditional law. And what is that condition? When physical conditions of conductors remain unchanged. We paused in this part. Or constant. Now in these physical conditions many things can come. Temperature can come, pressure can come, and even humidity. Yes. So when physical conditions of a conductor remain unchanged, then potential is directly proportional to current. Yes. So this was our Ohm's law. Yes, remember it? This was our Ohm's law. When physical conditions of a conductor remain unchanged, then potential difference is directly proportional to current. Yes, if the potential difference applied across the ends of a conductor, then potential difference will be directly proportional to current. Yes. Let us take an example. If this is at zero potential and this is at 10 volt and the current flowing is of 2 ampere. If the potential changes to 20 volt, it's doubled. The current will also get doubled. It will be 4 ampere. Yes, then you must have remembered the change in this potential was directly proportional to current. And if change is also directly proportional to current. Yes, if we are changing the potential, then current is also increased. So we can write del V upon del I. Because on changing the potential, the current is also getting increased. Yes. So we can write del V proportional to I. Now, we can write del V equals to IR. Remember it? There we used to write V is equals to IR. But here in this form, we will write del V upon del V is equals to IR. Where R is the resistance of conductor. So this is the resistance of conductor. Yes. And this R is constant for ohmic conductors. Constant for ohmic conductors. I told you in the class there are two types of conductors, ohmic and non-ohmic. Ohmic conductors, those who follow Ohm's law. Following Ohm's law means V proportional to I. Then there are non-ohmic which do not obey Ohm's law. Yes, and if I draw the graph for ohmic conductors, it will always come straight line. That is del V and I, then this slope will be straight line. And the slope, if I just draw the line and make here angle theta, then slope is equals to what? Tan theta, which will give you what? Del V upon I. That is equals to R, which is equals to constant. Got it? So 90% conductors, 90% or even I can say 95% of conductors in your course is ohmic because they follow Ohm's law. They are ohmic because they follow Ohm's law. Yes, when V will be increased, then I will also be increased. Yes. Now we will be proving the Ohm's law. Okay, we have to write the proof for the Ohm's law. In class 10th, you have not studied the proof, but now we will be writing the proof also for Ohm's law. Yes, so you know I is equals to Vena. Remember it? VDENA, drift velocity. Yes, then if you know the value of drift velocity also, we have done tau relaxation time upon ml, where E is the charge on electron, then V is the potential difference, tau is the relaxation time, the time of collision between two particles, then M is the mass and L is the what? Mass of electron, which is constant, and L is the length of conductor. Yes, now after this I can put the value of V from here. So instead of V I can write E V tau upon ML into E N A. On just cross multiplying it and by getting the value, what you will get? E square V tau N A M L. So this is the value which we will be getting. Yes, where E is, what is E? Charge on electron. Where V is potential difference. Yes, where this is tau, the relaxation time between two successive collisions of electrons. N is the number of electrons, A is the area of cross section, and M is the mass of electron, and L is the length of the conductor. Yes, now just put V here. We have to achieve V upon I. So if we reverse it, we'll make it V upon I. Or if you are getting confused, just what you do, I is here, call V over here. If you are calling V over here, it will come E square tau N A upon M L. Just reverse this relation, it will turn to V upon I M L E square tau N A. And this is what we were wanting, we were expecting it. Now just write the values. So where M is the mass of electron. So this is a constant term. M is a mass of electron, which is constant term. Where L is the length of conductor. So length of the conductor is also constant, I think. Yes. For one experiment, we will take only one single conductor, which will have a same length. Yes. Then N is also the number of free electrons. The number of free electrons per unit volume. So it is also constant, because if temperature will remain constant, the number of free electrons will also be constant. Yes, so it is dependent on temperature. Then tau, that is the average relaxation time, the time period between two collisions, and collision between what? Electron and kernel. So it is also the constant term, because if the temperature will constant, then there will be a definite time interval between two successive collisions. Yes, then there E is charge on electron, which is also constant, and then A is area of cross section. So you can see the all the quantities which is over here is constant. Yes. So if they all are constants, and then what we can write? V upon I is equals to constant. Yes, V upon I is a constant. And so we can write V proportional to I. So this is what Ohm's law says. Yes, what it says? It is V proportional to I. This is Ohm's law. Yes, so here we proved Ohm's law, because we have said all these quantities constant. I am just zooming it out. You can just make notes also.